Iron Maiden are clearly teasing something extraordinary in their Thank You Europe video, and I can't wait to find out what it actually is. So in case you guys missed it, Iron Maiden actually hit a couple of clues and hints in their recent Thank You Europe video, in which they of course thank the European fans for coming out and seeing their The Future Bass Tour show.
It has been amazing.
With the first one being that of Nico McBrain saying something like that.
Then we're going to take a little time off for ourselves because we're all old farts. Well, the rest of them are. And then we're going to think about what we're going to do after.
And I'll actually be honest with you, after Nico's latest health problems, I was actually slightly worried after hearing that message from him. Because let's be honest here, it can actually be read in two different ways.
Yeah, unbelievable.
But after that, Bruce Dickinson actually went on and said something that did not only calm me down, but actually made me and thousands of other Iron Maiden fans all around the world curious and eager to find out what did Iron Maiden actually prepare for us in 2024.
Something else will happen. I can't tell you what, but you'll be happy.
So what is it? What is that big surprise that Bruce teased in that video? Well, the most obvious assumption at this point, I guess, would be to assume that Bruce Dickinson simply spoke about his upcoming solo album, which, as we all know, he confirmed that we will hear after the end of Iron Maiden's tour.
When are we going to hear some new solo material? Soon. Obviously, there's going to be a Maiden tour in between me finishing the album and then you hearing it later.
But at the same time, first of all, none of this is actually big news. We all know and have been in the known for quite a while now that the work on Bruce Dickinson's upcoming solo album is almost finished.
Yes, that's true.
And two, well, this isn't really the most classy move to advertise your solo project in a video addressed to the fans of your main band, isn't it?
Yes.
So I personally guess that this is not what the boys have been talking about. And so another possibility, which has freaked out so many fans all across the world, and especially those beyond Europe, is if Iron Maiden actually ending the Future Bass Tour for good after their show on Power Trip, with no additional North and South American dates announced at all, neither for 2023 nor for 2024.
Why?
And well, I'll be honest with you, this is actually a possibility. Because let's be honest here, the Future Bass Tour is an enormous challenge for the band, and especially in their age. So there is actually a tiny chance that the band might end the Future Bass Tour, but I honestly do not believe in it at all. First of all, because whether they like it or not, but the fans might get really, really, and I mean really pissed if after all that hype and after years of begging the band to finally play it, the fans outside of Europe will not get to hear Alexander the Great live. And number two is simply because of the fact that we know for a fact that the Future Bass Tour is supposed to go until 2024 at the very least. And in addition to that, a little birdie told me that the band might actually return to Europe next year and perform a song about a man whose name struck fear in the hearts of men in the country where he actually was from. So I personally do not really think that the band will end the Future Bass Tour this year, but at the same time, as my friend Tom actually suggested, the boys might change the setlist quite a bit, keeping all of those songs from Somewhere in Time, yet at the same time changing at least most of the songs from Senjutsu for better known tunes, in order to be able to make this tour a little bit more attractive for wider audiences. Cause let's be honest here, all of us diehard Iron Maiden fans of course love this deep cut setlist, yet many casual fans are actually not too excited about an Iron Maiden show without Run to the Hills in it. But at the same time, there is actually one more possibility here. And I know that it is a stretch, but it is nevertheless a possibility. You see, despite the whole fact that Iron Maiden's latest studio album, Senjutsu, was released not so long ago, it was actually recorded 4.5 years ago and was probably written way before that.
Wrote the songs or finished writing the songs all here in the studio.
And so while it is still fresh and new in our minds, it actually is already an old story for the boys at Iron Maiden. And so maybe, just maybe, the boys actually prepared something new for us, as if in new music from Iron Maiden. Either a full-length album or an EP consisting of brand new songs. As yes, it is true that it is actually very early for Iron Maiden to release new music at this point.
Exactly.
Because let's be honest here, they're just now, a couple of years after it's released, are properly getting to touring in support of their latest studio album. But at the same time, the whole news about Nico's health and all of the other news surrounding the band actually make me believe that the boys might actually understand that the end of their journey together of an Iron Maiden band as we know it today is nearing its end, and that if they have some new music in stock, since after 2019 they had plenty of time to write new material, they might actually push a little bit harder and release it while they still can tour together, while they still enjoy it, and while all of their fans are still eagerly anticipating for it. And if you were actually able to witness the Future Past tour at state at the venue until the very end, you might have actually noticed how warm was the atmosphere between the boys on stage, how much they supported each other, how much they seemed to truly enjoy performing together, and how much love they have been shown to Nico McBrain lately. And so yes, while it is still a little bit of a stretch, the truth is that we might actually get to hear some new material from one of the greatest heavy metal bands on earth. Or at least some news or hints of the boys going into the studio to record it very, very soon. But one thing is absolutely clear, that it's going to be something extraordinary, because simply take a look at Bruce's face. He clearly really, really wants to tell us something, and it's clearly a face of a person who is either dying to tell you a secret or simply enjoys the fact that he will now try to break your head finding out what exactly it is. Yeah. Oh, and by the way, guys, in case you're wondering what a happy background I have in this video, the reason for it is because I'm recording it while on my way back from Wacken Open Air to Ukraine. And I'm currently somewhere in Poland and stopped by a McDonald's to simply record this video for you guys. After I spent the past 2 days after Wacken Open Air purchasing medical supplies for Ukrainian civilians that you guys helped me raise the funds for. And at this point, my car is actually full of them, but it will still be making at least two more bunches of purchases in the coming weeks. So if you guys were among those who were able to donate for that fundraiser, I'm truly, truly so thankful for you for making this trip to Wacken Open Air actually count for Ukrainian civilians. And if you guys still don't know what I'm talking about, or if you would like to donate but still haven't had a chance to do so, just FYI, the fundraiser will be open for next 2 weeks, as I'll be releasing videos from Wacken Open Air. So I encourage each and every one of you to check out metalpilgrim.net/Wacken and help us show that metalheads are one of the most loving and caring communities out there.
I love it!
But anyways, what do you guys personally think those hints in Iron Maiden videos actually mean? Please let us know in the comments. As always, thank you so much for watching this very short and spontaneous video, guys, and we will prevail. Slava Ukraini!